Our top story this afternoon. A couple of hours ago, the South Korean parliament has passed a record budget for next year. The budget bill amounts to over 515 billion U.S. dollars, with much of the money going into pandemic recovery. For more on this, we connect to our political correspondent Lee Kyung-eun, who's on the line for us. Kyung-eun, this is by far the biggest budget, right?
That's right, Mo Kyung-eun. The 2022 budget is worth some 515 billion U.S. dollars. That's reflecting the latest currency. That's around $2.8 billion more than the government's initial proposal and the biggest one ever. More than one-tenth of the budget, some $57 billion, is actually going into helping small businesses hit by the pandemic. First, by direct compensation, with businesses getting a minimum of $425. Second, by boosting domestic consumption by rolling out $25 billion of local currency coupons. The budget for antivirus health care has also increased from the previous $1.1 billion to nearly $6 billion. The money will be used to secure antiviral pills for some 400,000 people and add 4,000 hospital beds for severely ill patients. As to prevent another urea water solution shortage, the government set aside an emergency fund to be used in securing urea and other raw materials in emergency situations.
Now, Kyung-eun, the budget bill was supposed to be passed last night, but what caused the delay?
That's why Thursday was the legal deadline for the passage, but negotiations between the rival parties went on until the last minute, causing a delay in the computation work at the Finance Ministry. But the National Assembly Speaker Park Byung-suk said it should technically be counted as within the deadline. At the center of the controversy is some $6 million of the Defense Ministry's budget that will go towards building the country's first light aircraft carrier. The Navy has sought to build a 30,000-ton carrier by 2033 to ramp up deterrence and long-range operational capability. The main opposition People Power Party said such an expensive project should be left for the next administration to consider when it takes office in May. However, the ruling Democratic Party maintained that the project cannot be delayed any further. That's all for now. Thank you, Mo Kyung-eun.
Thank you for the report, Kyung-eun. We appreciate it.